My name is Kim Odlaug. My husband is Andrew Odlaug, and we have a beautiful 17-month-old daughter, Anna Odlaug.
Anna is our firstborn, our first child. She was born in late September of 2017. Our journey with her and Dravet began in January, late January of 2018, at the age of 4 months, when Anna suffered a prolonged 30-minute seizure after her routine 4-month vaccinations. Of course, it was unexpected and, you know, very frightening. We ended up at the ER with her. They performed all the tests they could, and, you know, everything came back normal, so they sent us home. 2 months later, we went back to the pediatrician, and she had her routine 6-month vaccinations. Once again, about 8 hours later, she had a prolonged 30-minute seizure, and we ended up back at the ER. Our journey since has been, you know, we're approaching a year now since she's had her diagnosis. We've certainly had some difficult days and some, you know, tough times with her. We took her out to Colorado in June of last year, and about 24 hours after we arrived, we were sitting down at the dinner table with the family, and she started having a seizure. It ended up lasting almost an hour, and her and Kim were airlifted down to the Denver Children's Hospital. We spent a day there, and then we came home. So at that point, you know, her diagnosis became a lot more real to us. That was the first prolonged seizure she had had since, you know, since her vaccines and since she had been diagnosed. We started her on the ketogenic diet, which the classic ketogenic diet, which is known to be an effective treatment for, you know, certain types of epilepsy, Dravet syndrome in particular. She's been on the diet now for about 6 months, and, you know, it's been going well for us. She also is taking the recently FDA-approved and first medical marijuana product known as Epidiolex, which is a pure cannabidiol CBD product, as a treatment for her condition as well. And she's been on Epidiolex now for a couple months. Overall, Anna's been doing great. She's recently started walking. She's very happy. She's active. And she's full of life, also very chatty. It's been a difficult winter for us, to say the least. She's, you know, dealing with cold and flu season. It seems like she's been pretty consistently been getting sick over the past couple months. Back on January the 19th, Anna did have another prolonged seizure, again triggered by illness, and we found out, you know, pneumonia. That seizure lasted almost 4 hours.
Anna and I were out. We're at Whole Foods picking up some food. We were gonna have some friends over for brunch the next morning, and she was laughing and smiling and just, you know, in the cart. She kind of looked up for a second and she started having a seizure. I, you know, called Andrew's name over, and we tried to stop it. We couldn't. So from there, we, you know, called 911. The ambulance came, and we were at the hospital for an entire week. You know, came back home a week the next weekend. It was kind of crazy, but that was by far the scariest moment of, you know, both Andrew and I, both of our lives. You know, they couldn't stop the seizure, and we also were worried, is she gonna have any, you know, brain injury when she wakes up? Is, you know, it's a life-threatening disease, and, you know, that was the scariest moment of our lives. And I think ever since we've been home, you know, we still live our lives day to day. She hasn't had a terrible seizure since, but we still live our lives day to day. You know, it doesn't define Anna. She's the sweetest, happiest girl that we know. She's so playful. She loves people. She lights up when anyone walks in the door. She gets sad when they leave. She's a little ham in all of her classes. She loves her music class. She's just the sweetest, happiest girl, and she's doing so well. You know, after that really long seizure, she actually started to walk the week after we got home from the hospital, which is just truly amazing. And saying some of her, you know, saying some new words. She walked up to Andrew and said, "Hi, Daddy," the other day, which just made us all laugh. So she's doing really great, but it does, you know, we have a constant fear in the back of our minds, you know, like every single night when she's going to bed. It's hard to go to sleep because we just want to make, you know, we're watching her on the monitor, or just, you know, every single day is just, we're so relieved and so happy that she's happy and healthy. But we also know that we are lucky because there are many children who don't have seizures as infrequently as Anna, and that hers are tied to illness. I know as you get older, many children start to have seizures daily, and they can have 100 seizures a day. So it is also in the back of our minds of, you know, not knowing, knowing what the outcome of the prognosis of what this condition is, and just not knowing how, how it will be for Anna.
When it rains, it pours, but you didn't even notice. It ain't raining anymore. It's hard to breathe when all you know is the struggle of staying above the rising water line. Well, the sky is finally open, the rain and wind stop blowing, but you're stuck out in the same old storm again. You hold tight to your umbrella. Well, darling, I'm just trying to tell you that there's always been a rainbow hanging over your head. If you could see